What is going on, guys? Welcome back. Commentary for you. My goodness, we have the largest day of drama I can remember in a very long time. Chantal has been live, absolutely raging. FFG has a premiere set for 6 p.m. titled Bud Tender Confirmed. Haram Footy Beauty's been beezing. It has an image of Chantal outside of one plant. And according to FFG, she has went out to the store Chantal has been going to, spoke to one of the employees, and they have outed Chantal. Once Chantal sees this, she comes online. Her title indicates she's still smoking. She has to put on some lip balm, and she starts raging. She says FFG has no life and no man energy. She then goes on to talk about how FFG is going to multiple dispensaries to see if she's been buying it, and she offers that she hasn't been lying about this because it's no one's business. She says at this point, FFG needs a restraining order, that going out and doing this is not content, and she says the person from one plant recognized her when she walked into the store, and that she had been concerned about this, because evidently, as she went on, maybe these two people went to school together, maybe Chantal felt intimidated by her in the past, but clearly she knew that there was going to be an issue. She does go on and say that she's been smoking. She was smoking when she was in Thailand. She then said she's not going to address this anymore, and repeats throughout the stream she's not going back to Canada ever. She says all this does is make FFG look crazy, and just continues to project about the legal action she wants to do. She then goes on and again just talks about how she wasn't getting wheelchairs. She's deleting super chats left and right. She says that no one else is God or the morality police, and that she's been doing this in the evening, and that's all there was to it. She continues to cite that everyone is just demented. She also says that she's not simply been staying at her mother's, and she just gets more and more angry as this stream kind of builds. She thanks FFG for the clout and says all publicity is good publicity. She talks about Pete's knowing some comic book artist that knows Chantal from online drama. She says that FFG simply lives in her dust, and that FFG will never have a Hameo. She'll never have a 100K plaque. And to that point, I don't think Chantal is going to get that 100K plaque. And she says none of us will have this content once she gets back to Kuwait. And she says the smoking, it's been helping her. She's not afraid to admit it. She says this is secondhand embarrassment, calling all these places, offering this was a massive breach of privacy. She says this is nothing more than bullying someone for income. She, again, has this insistence that she can't be canceled. This is her life. These are her rights. She isn't inventing her life. And that most people should have known simply by watching she was still smoking. That all of this really isn't a big deal. The reality is, she continues to be mad that FFG does this and gets content from it. She says that the comments are going to be off, more so after the issues with Salah. She says the person working at the store is going to be in trouble for this, that she's going to go to the manager. She said she has no idea how people are allowed to be so invasive of her privacy. She says FFG will end up in jail, not totally for this, but just as a blanket statement. And the chat actually tells her to stop talking about it and actually do it. Make some type of action against it. She said she didn't have time to do anything legally while she was back. And she actually takes a bathroom break at that point. When she comes back, she says FFG actually is going to damage this person's business because this is going to be reported. She then goes on to contradict much of the beginning of the stream and says that the weed doesn't even help her anymore. She said she's only been Muslim for a year. She smoked for 30 plus years prior to that. And this shouldn't be that big of a shock to people, that she's not going to simply just give it up, and she's still struggling with her revert. She then turns this into other channels not camming up, Yabba, myself, she's not supporting Salah financially. Listen, at the end of the day, Chantal, here's the reality. You help all of this become an issue. Your take now of nobody cares is such a contradiction to you lying about it, because that is why people care. You can't lie about something. You can't try to cover something up. And then when you get outed, say, oh, no one should care. You all knew this. Why is this a problem? You made it a problem for yourself. And for you to come online after you've been outed, right? This is the only reason you came online is you saw FFG's video. You saw the thumbnail. You knew the gig was up. This is no different than what happened with Salah. See, Salah knew the gig was up as well. He knew the messages came out. He knew he had nowhere to hide. He knew that the truth was going to be shown. So he had to come out. You very much had the same exact predicament today. So you can't make it this issue when you're working so hard to cover it up that in one breath say it's not a big deal, and then in the other hand, constantly lie about it. Also, you use your religion as a way to project yourself over people all the time. And clearly, you were doing a lot of things, and Salah for that matter, that don't align with those beliefs. And to sit there in this video and even bring up Kaybella, bring up Kaya again, and saying that you weren't lying about this, that you only went two or three times, and that Salah himself is known. Again, excusing it away as your addictive personality, and that you shouldn't have to defend yourself over this, that you've constantly told us you're not a perfect Muslim. It's not defending yourself against your action, Chantal. It's acknowledging that you are lying to your entire audience, both Beezers and non-Beezers alike. The people that support you, the people that constantly say, good job, you're doing so great, we're proud you're a Muslim, we know this is a challenge. You're lying to them just as much as you're lying to everyone else in the community that you believe hates you. You allow all of this to be an issue because you lie so aggressively. You defend so aggressively. And then you want to blame everything on being impulsive. The proof in the fact that you went home to deal with weight loss and legal issues, and we now know you've done nothing. You couldn't even get the basic steps done toward regarding things with FFG. If you had, could you imagine how this would have looked on top of that? If you would even take the first step regarding all of these complaints you have about her content, right? And you documented it. And then now you have her going to places you've went. Sometimes I think we get lost in how this looks to us in the community. But how would this look to someone outside of the community that doesn't understand what's going on? They would look at it as two people making content about each other all the time, and then all of a sudden, someone starts contacting places this person has been, perhaps even showing up at one. If you just look at it in that context, and you don't know that Chantal is constantly egging all of this on, which clearly they're probably not going to sit there and watch hours upon hours upon hours of content, honestly, Chantal would have served herself rather well toward making a compelling case if she had sat down and documented anything, but we know that she won't, she knows that she won't, and FFG knows that she can't. She says that she's never going to go back to Canada. She says this is the perfect excuse as to why, that she needs to get help with her mental, and she's going to do that in Kuwait, and that if she needs to see her family anymore, she'll simply meet them in Florida. This, surmising the video at the end, shows us everything. Everything wrong with Chantal. She's going to run away from even more problems. She's going to run away from doing things she shouldn't be doing. And she's going to make a commitment to her audience and herself that once she just gets somewhere else, she's going to make all the changes she needs. She's going to have the positive in her life that she desires. But she never follows through. In Kuwait, Canada was going to be the savior. In the doctor's office, we were going to go back to Canada. We were going to go home, get the surgery, get our lives back in order, pay our debts, and everything was going to be fine. She was going to handle FFG, BBJ. Everything was going to be right in the world. Well, now here we are, a week away, apparently, before going back to Kuwait. We've addressed none of those things. And we're saying, well, once I get to Kuwait, everything's going to be great again. I'm going to get my mental in order. I'm going to have Salah again. Chantal, rather than sit there and tell everyone else that they're unhappy in their life, rather than sit there and say everyone else has all these problems, why don't you ever address the problems you have, both with yourself and with others? And I think if you do that, you'll find yourself truly happy and satisfied in a way that you're never going to be running all over the world to get away from your problems. And if you think validation is held within Salah, Kuwait, and also that 100,000 subscriber plaque you constantly bring up. You realize you're setting yourself up for failure when those things don't arrive or don't see themselves through. If you don't get the plaque, which you more than likely won't based on the track record of your channel, you have any idea how people are going to respond? It is going to continually be a joke that you've made yourself the center of. I'm going to leave you with the top comments from the last video. Appreciate you watching this one. You know I will be back as soon as I can with more content.